Have you tried to create dimensions with Dynamo? In this video, I will show you how to make them, but how to download the files so you can actually use them. Shall we? A few months ago, I created this video to explain how to build a Dynamo script for creating grid dimensions. This script lets you pick multiple parallel grids and automatically generates those dimensions. I'll leave the link to this video over here so you can click on it and watch the full video and see how did I make it. However, if you want to know how to download the file and get the most out of it, stay around until the end of the video and I'll guide you not only through downloading it, but also through using it properly. To explain how it works, I'll be using this sample project from Revit 2021. Okay, so I'll start showing you this plan view in which there are many dimensions on the grid. I'm just gonna get rid of them and tidy it up so we can see clearly when we create the dimensions. I'm gonna move this one in this way and this one on this way as well. Now I'm just going to call the Dynamo player, which is in the manage tab. So I click on here. As you can see, we have two files here. We are going through those files. The first one is the one that I created in the video that I showed you before. So now I'm going to access to the settings of this file. I'm gonna hit select and select all the grids from 1 to 7. I'm gonna hit play and there they are, my dimensions. However, there are some limitations about this method. Let me isolate the grid so you can see it better. First one is that you need to select all the grids that you need to dimension at once, meaning that you select all of this and you hit play and you get your dimension. However, if you select separately, let's say for example this one and then these other ones, after hitting OK, it doesn't look quite good. So the only way to get one dimension for all the grids, you need to select them all at once. So I'm gonna hit again select and select all the horizontal grids, and now it looks much better. The next thing we need to think about it is that this file works only for parallel grids. It means if I select by mistake, for example, the grid A as well, when I hit play, I'm gonna have this window, and if I remove the reference, it looks quite good. However, not always is the case. I'm gonna try again selecting these grids, and when I hit play, pops up the same error, and this time it's not a good result. Now imagine that you want to select all the grids at once, only to find that it is the same kind of problem all the time. So to solve this problem, I've created this new file, this is the second one, which is easier to use. In this one, you don't need to select anything, you just hit play and all the dimension comes up automatically. So now these two files complement each other. For instance, in the case we have a project with inclined grids, for example, let's say 8, 9 and 10 are in this angle, the second file is not working. Let me show you. I'm gonna get rid of this again. I'm gonna hit play and it's only the horizontal and vertical grids. So I can use the first one, select only those grids and then hit play so I can get this dimension as well. Likewise, I can add more dimension to my plan view by selecting more grids again. So I can select these three. And there we go. Now I'm gonna try it with the same files, but now it's in Revit 2024. I'm gonna use this sample file, which is in imperial dimensions, but it's the same. So I'm gonna get rid of them to start over again, and I'm gonna call my Dynamo player. In Revit 2024, you have many folders. So I'm gonna choose this one and I'm gonna have the same two files that I used in Revit 2021. So I'm going to start with the second one, which is the one that creates the general dimensions, and I'm going to tidy it up a little bit. I'm just going to move this one here and move this one as well over here. And if I want it, I can create more dimensions by clicking on this one, select, and just selecting some of them. In this case, I'm gonna select 5 to 8. I'm gonna hit run, and there is all my dimensions. So now I can play around, and that's it. So if you want to download both files, you can find it in the link in the description of this video, which is taking you to this page. So we have the two files over here. The first one with only the parallel dimension, and the second one contains the two files. To get the first one, you can type here 0 and click on the ping button. So after here, you just only need to type your email address and you will be able to download the file. So that's it. Thank you for watching it.